What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. I'm at my next service call. Customer's got a Bradford White, I think it's a 50-gallon gas-fired water heater. It's got some leakage coming from the temperature and pressure safety relief valve. You know, that valve, that brass-looking thing on the side of the water heater that goes off at 212 degrees or 150 PSI. You know, that safety valve. You know what I'm talking about, right? Well, it's discharging some water. And the homeowner's worried about the condition of the tank and the water, but it was only installed about 2 years ago. So why would the temperature and pressure, the T&P valve, you know, the 100XL, why would that be dripping? All right, so we have some discharge here on the temperature and pressure safety valve, the T&P valve, the relief valve. We're going to flush out this tank. It's due for it. And when we're flushing it out and we drain a little bit of the water from the tank, we're gonna change that T&P valve and put in a new one with a drip leg, code compliant and proper, you know? That's the way we roll at Pipe Doctor. All right. I got the end of the hose here into this white bucket. All right, it's outside in the backyard. It's got some purple primer residue in there, but I'm doing this for a reason. Well, here's the water main. This is feeding, it looks like 1 inch copper coming into this 5/8 meter. Mm-hmm. Yeah, 5/8. And then it goes to 3/4. This is the valve before the meter, ball valve, which is nice. I'm sorry, after the meter. This is the ball valve before the meter, which also works good. And then you have this T on the domestic water line coming here before this filtration system. But this T and this valve, this goes to your irrigation system, right? And this thing right here, this is a very simple device. It allows water to travel only one direction. It's not a backflow prevention device, which is required when you have an irrigation system for your lawn, but it's a check valve. And this is probably a spring check valve or like a flap check valve. So water only goes one direction. So those temperature and pressure safety valves, like your water heater is leaking, normally when you have a closed system. If this or something similar to this was installed here on the water main itself, that is the reason why your relief valve is dripping and you would need what we call a domestic thermal expansion tank, which is a bladder, which is a roughly around 4 gallons of size, 4 point something gallons of size, right? And it automatically absorbs pressure in a closed system. Now the hot water system, your domestic water system is a closed system when there's no faucets open. If no one's using the water, the hot water in the home, it's a closed system, right? But because it's a vessel or a tank, which is an automatic storage tank for domestic hot water, it is always being heated. A temperature is always being maintained. Mm-hmm. So as water is heated in a closed loop system, right? If nothing's open, right? The water expands. And hence the need for a domestic thermal expansion valve, a domestic thermal expansion tank when you have a closed system. Now you don't have a closed system because there's nothing here that lets water travel only one direction. But you have it here, but this is, I'm not too concerned about this, but this may be a problem. Though I don't know, I'm not, this is by probably Haig or, mm-hmm. right? Oh, I was close. I don't even recognize the icon on the logo. But this, you may, who services the water filtration system?
So I had one of the guys come in.
Long Island Clean Water or something?
Something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, these are salt tanks, Brian?
Yeah, this is salt tank.
Okay, and the... Someone takes care of that for you every so often?
I just
know, it's a steam pipe. You may want to check, see if these have are preventing water from only going one direction. Because okay. That's the case, this is going to reoccur again. And if it does, you have to install a rather expensive tank that hangs from the water supply to prevent from that happening again.
Oh, those big
It's not so big. It's not so big, but it's like a small pail. like a half the size of a 5 gallon bucket. Okay. Matter of fact, one of these tanks fit in a 5 gallon bucket easily. Wow. Yeah, just don't, you know, otherwise it would suck. But yeah. So I'm going to flush your tank. So it's only a couple years old. Now, you would not normally do this. If this tank was 5, 6, 7, 8 years old, you wouldn't ever do this because you're going to pull the skin off your, the scale off your skin. And, but it's only 2 years old, we could do this. Not even 2 years, because this is 2023. Mm-hmm. Who installed it? Or came with the house?
Came with the house.
Or at least you know we were here for the boiler. And I'll do a quick little cleanup on this as well.
You came for me?
Yeah. Got a washing machine hose to my pump. This is a little Liberty 331. And then I have my garden hose going outside into that bucket. Now, let's open up that valve. And it's not really a full port valve, but it's good enough. All right, let's go see what's going on outside. All right. We are flushing out the bottom of the tank. I did not close the water heater supply valve. I did have this going into a bucket because I want that iron that's gonna be here to sit at the bottom of this 5 gallon bucket a little bit later. Let that settle down and you'll see what I'm talking about. We're gonna close the supply valve, feeding the water, domestic cold water. Let's put this on pilot lighting. Your valve may be different, your gas control valve may be different, but we're on pilot lighting. I'm gonna close the domestic cold water, and then I'm gonna pop open the relief valve so I don't create that vacuum. You notice as soon as I close that, the pitch of my pump changed. Okay? So we're gonna pump some water out of here. All right, while it's pumping down, I'm gonna use this time to take out the temperature and pressure valve. You can use a pipe wrench or, wow, that was just like hands tight. Wow, look at that. No real effort there required. I got a new one ready. I'm gonna throw a little Teflon tape on the end of it. Even though it comes with a little PTFE tape on it already. We are gonna put a little extra on it. Now watch, ladies and gentlemen, how I do this. This is only one real way of wrapping Teflon tape around threads. See how I'm doing this, ladies and gentlemen? There's no other way of doing this, okay? Prove me wrong. Six times around. I'll show that to you guys in a hot minute. Come on, baby. I'm getting a little ahead of myself here. All right, hold on. Come on. You think I wasn't gonna put one on here? On it. There you go. Easy peasy. Yeah, just about 6 inches off the floor there, folks. There you go. So if there was a valve that lets water travel only in the one direction here, all right, you're gonna need to install a domestic thermal expansion tank on a properly secured pipe or secured to like a foundation wall, framing of the home, and pipe that into the domestic cold water. So I wouldn't hang it here because This is not really being held up with anything other than a zip tie. Can't make that up, folks. Can't make that up. And what really should be done here, all of the 2-inch steam piping here really should be insulated. They're losing so much heat. Oh, it's a shame. It really is. Well, you know what? It looks like it was leaking from the actual... Wow. Crazy. Now, I was hoping to show you more of the iron in here, but you could see it settling at the bottom of this bucket now. All right. And that's even with the water filter on the water main. But it's not terrible. It's not terrible. But yeah, mostly sediment. But not terrible. Mostly sediment. So the water softening system that they have is doing something, thank God. So not terrible. All right, let's not forget to put the water heater back to temperature. Otherwise, you'll have a recall if you're a plumber for no hot water. Or if you're a homeowner, you'll have no hot water and your wife's gonna yell at you. Very nice. If you want any stickers, email me, Mike@mikeypipes.com.